What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So I hope you are not mad with me regarding the last video when I was joking about leaving aquascaping. So here it is, the new aquascape, the new 90 centimeters home tank, completely different approach from what I had before. So if you are new to my channel, so I will place the link down below. From the previous scape is something completely different from what I have done now. And the reason to make something like this was just to give a little bit more of space for the livestock. There is two ways to do aquascaping. One of them is just spend a lot of time just playing around with the hardscape, select wisely which plants we're going to use, because the target is completely different. We're going to submit that for a contest, for example, like the previous aquascape. But this one, and since I had the Microgeophagus ramirez German blue in this tank, I decided just to make something more open, I would say a little bit more free space just for them to swim. Of course, they will still keep their territory. They will be aggressive when they spawn and lay the eggs over the rocks or over the sand, but it's quite normal. But in this way, they will have more space just to fight. They will not be so confined to a tight space like they were before. And I have done this in one single day, and I treat this like a tank when I usually escape something for an exhibition. So let's see some footage from that 2 weeks ago when I was explaining all the steps and all the preparation before I just started. Okay, we have here a bunch of stuff. It looks like a big, big mess. I have some gloves when I'm going to use the glue. I have some tissue paper bucket where I'm going to take the equipment inside of the tank and place it over here just to clean. Then I have some root tubs, this from Seacan and also from Aquario. We have iron, potassium, also some micros and macros. This is a mix of elements. This is more or less the same like the normal ones, but they last longer. Because if you want to keep a tank, for example, for more than 12 months, it will be quite good to use these ones too, okay? Then we have some brush, tweezers, super glue, a cutter, some soil, because I will not do the same mistake like I did before on my kitchen tank, because the kitchen tank I forgot just to cover and put the last layer because I'm reusing the same soil. This is used for smash a little bit of the soil because this soil is dry and I want to pour a little bit of soil over the parts where I'm going to join with the super glue. Then over here we have some gravel that I'm going to use. This is from Prodivio, is Gitche Serious gravel. We have different sizes. This is the medium one, the small one, okay, and the bigger one. I intend to do this just for details. We have a water spray. We need to have the water spray at least while we are planting, depending on the time that we're going to take. Then I have here prime, because I intend to save at least 50% of the water that is in the tank. And then it's like doing a 50% water change, but I want to take the fish out in the same day and put them again. So we have here a bunch of plants from Aquaflora. I will try to make a different layout, completely different stuff from what I had before. We have this and a few more plants over here, but I will show you the list later. And also how I'm preparing the plants, how I usually plant it, where I choose that place to put it there. Also, I have here a big hose or a larger one. I have here a protection on the edge just to avoid the fish being sucked. Then for the hardscape, I have here big lava stones, you see, black lava. Also a brush case something is a little bit dirty. and a small hammer just to make some details or break some rocks. Then in the other side, this took me a while just to prepare everything and put it over here, what I really wanted to do, what I need. I don't have a drawing in my head, but I know exactly what I want to create. This is scaping twigs, very tiny branches, similar to azalea. I'm going to use this for fine details to the wood. This box, I have also medium and small lava rocks that I'm going to use more in the front of the tank, okay? And here I have hornwood, okay? I decided to use this one. I like wood very much, and this one is a little bit dark, heavier too, and completely different from what I have used so far, okay? Here I have a container. This takes around 50 liters of water. This is where I'm going to store some of the water. That is nice because there is an opening here, and then we can put the water inside of the tank, okay? And here, this is where I'm going to put the fish while I am scaping, okay? This is a styrofoam box. I will have some water over here, then place the fish. I will not intend to cover it completely, otherwise they will remove most of the oxygen inside of the box. Then here it is, the tank. I already removed most of the stem plants, or almost, I think all of them, they are gone. I already start preparing this. There is some algae on it, because this tank is being neglected for 1 week and a half, more or less. And because I already knew what I wanted to do, I wanted to finally escape. And if I left the stem plants over there, probably I was going to postpone 1 week more and one more and one more. And this is why this also lasts for 17 months. One thing that is really, really important is the way are you going to prepare your filter in order to keep all the biological stuff intact for, in order that you can put the fish back in the tank again. So what I'm going to do, I just take the filter out. I will remove the mechanical filtration. This is only a small layer that I have inside, and 90% of the filter is with the biological stuff. I will take it, put it on a balcony. We need to keep the bucket open so it can get oxygen. You can keep it with water in it, because if you take the water, probably the bacteria will die. So just keep the water. But if you keep it, the filter closed, what will end up is you're going to kill all the bacteria, because you're going to have a big pike, a big peak of ammonia. So CO2 is already off too, because I don't need for the moment. So first step is just take some water for this container, also that one, and then start to drain. Because when we drain the entire tank, just leaving a little bit of water, the fish will be less stressful, and then you can catch them really, really fast. This is probably one of the most time-consuming parts of all this process, because I had to get all the fish out of the tank, acclimatize in the styrofoam box, and then later on take everything out from the tank because I want to reuse the soil. After taking all the hardscape and all the roots I could, it's better just to flood the tank once or twice, just to try to clean the soil the much you can before you start the new process, that is starting your hardscape. Okay, for the moment I have the tank completely clean. This is the same soil that I have used on the previous scape. I just wash it a little bit, then took also a little bit of the soil that was inside, because you guys remember that it was a V shape, two slopes from the two sides. So I had to take a little bit of the soil because I want to make a triangular shape. But in the way that I still have a lot of space, just to see the livestock. As you guys can see, I have the sofa over here. So the idea is just to look to the scape from the two sides, from this corner and also from this side. So we can just enjoy a little bit more the depth of the tank, because from the other side of the tank, there is nothing over there. But from here, at least we can enjoy a little bit more of the space and have the fish just to swim. Now it comes the best part, or the part that I like more, is just to build the hardscape. I expect to do this more or less in 1 hour, probably more if I will be working a little bit on the details. But now let's get it started. Now is when the fun begins. Okay, see you guys in a minute. Usually I never prepare my hardscape in advance. I like to improvise a lot, and since the soil is wet, it is much easier to place bigger rocks because they will not slide. I start always by a focal point or a bigger rock, and then let them the others flow. After I place them more or less in the area that I want to recreate, give the volume and the shape, we start by adding the driftwood. That one, or the first one, will be always the focal point or the highest part in the layout, where we usually look to it for the first time. Then I need to play a little bit more with the wood, just trying to give more depth as possible and also more detail. After this part is being done, we need to be sure that the wood will not float, because I didn't put this wood in water. So the better way, just to be sure they will not float, is by adding a little bit of tissue paper between the wood and rock. Add some a little bit of super glue, and then you can use some dry soil. If you smash it, just by covering the tissue paper will look a little bit more natural, and we don't look or see the spots where the parts or the piece of hardscape have been glued. Now this is the part that I like more, is just painting your canvas and give some color. I have started by Pogostemon elferi. Is a small rosette plant, will grow in a small bush, but the color of it and the volume will give in some special place will give a nice contrast with all the other plants that I have selected. I am using mostly air grass tiles because I want to recreate a river stream, and right now I am planting Liliopsis Nova Zelandae. I like to use this plant very much, and mostly in the lower part, because I know by trimming it one or twice they will become shorter. And then of course I need to add my own Juncus repens, because those Juncus repens will give always a nice and wild look to an aquascape. Then we start by adding some Elantium Bolivian Madagascariensis. Is a very small Echinodorus compared to all the other ones that they are broadleaf, and adding more air grass style foreground plants like Heliocaris acicularis, just to mix it up a little bit more and make it a little bit more complex, more detailed. Because when we recreate something that is a little bit simple on in one single color, playing a little bit with the thickness and also by the shades of green that they have, will turn the layout more interesting. Also added some Eriocallum dongia between the rocks. Then I start by adding the gravel, just by covering the soil, because that will make a division, avoid the soil just to slide towards the sand, and add a few more plants just to give a little bit more of details and contrast, like Cryptocoryne parva, Cryptocoryne willisii, that we place a little bit more background. And then start to prepare all depthified plants just to place on the wood. But before, on the areas that we have the soil to the gravel, I have used some Heliocaris sp minima, because it's short plant a short foreground plant, and they will blend perfectly, because if I have used Elecara siculares, it will be too tall, and I want a low demanding planted tank. So the shorter air grass in the front will look always much better. I left the Cyperus alfaeri to the end because I want to use them mostly in the highest part of layouts, just to give that curtain, that flow, that movement. I end up by clipping all the big leaves just to make it better to adapt to the water conditions and get all the plants growing more or less in the same way. Then it is time just to glue some of the heptified plants like Microsorum Spatyrops Mini or Petit. All those plants were supplied by Aquaflora, and I am really sorry because I don't have the complete footage of all planting, because afterwards I added also some Anubias, Christmas moss, some Bobidis, but unfortunately they are not in this footage. Maybe something went wrong with the recording, but you will going to see that in the video of the day after I flood the tank, where the fish or the livestock was already inside of the tank and with nice coloration. In my last aquascapes, even the ones that I recreate and during some workshops in some shops, I will start being known by mixing up and blending a lot of stem plants, trying to make it with more contrast and detail as possible. And this tank is not that different. So I have used more or less the same shape, is air grass style, even the Nubias, the most pointy ones that I could find, just to mimic or mix it up or blend it some different species. So in order that we can look to it, we'll give that depth to the tank, mostly when the using of Elenthium madagascariensis. This is a small Echinodorus, but since we know that all Echinodorus tend to be with the broadleaf and very, very tall, by using them, and since they spread on the tank, they recreate the depth that I want, that upper scale that will try to fool everybody that this is not a 90 centimeters tank, but something that is a little bit bigger. By using also Cyperus alferi, Heliocaris vivipara, Heliocaris acicularis, is all air grass. They will grow in a different ways, so I can just control the volume as I want and also make the triangular shape work perfectly in this layout. Okay, so now let me show you some panoramic view of this layout. I hope you have enjoyed it. I will try to get back to you in the future with some maintenance, how I usually take care of that, water change, cleaning glass, what kind of preparation I may need to do just to get rid of some algae in case they appear. But I will keep you posted. See you guys in the next video. Take good care of yourself.